We shall never know all the good that a simple smile can do. With this beautiful quote, let us begin our ceremony.
அனைவருக்கும் அன்பான காலை வணக்கம். ரோகிணி பொறியியல் மற்றும் தொழில்நுட்ப கல்லூரியின் மின்னியல் மற்றும் மின் அணுவியல் துறையின் தொழில்நுட்ப கலந்தாய்விற்கு உங்கள் அனைவரையும் வருக வருக என வரவேற்கிறோம். நன்றி.
Good morning to all. Thank you for coming. Lakmi riba me apum na bu ne ta khong bom na khorum jari. Ngasi pangthok sariba technical symposium ilegyuba 2K2022 Department of Electrical and Electronics Rohini College of Engineering and Technology Lakmi riba me apuraku ayang na khorum jari. Welcome you all.
Ellavarkum namaskaram. Rohini College of Engineering and Technology le Electrical and Electronic Engineering Department nadathuna ELECU 2022 National Level Technical Symposium le എല്ലാവർക്കും എന്റെ സ്വാഗതം. നന്ദി, നമസ്കാരം.
വെരി ഗുഡ് മോർണിംഗ് ടു ഓൾ. ഐ ടേക്ക് പ്രിവിലേജ് ടു വെൽക്കം യു ഓൾ ഫോർ ദ ടെക്നിക്കൽ സിമ്പോസിയം ELECU 2K22 കണ്ടക്ടഡ് ബൈ ദി ഡിപ്പാർട്ട്മെന്റ് ഓഫ് ഇലക്ട്രിക്കൽ ആൻഡ് ഇലക്ട്രോണിക്സ് എഞ്ചിനീയറിംഗ് റോഹിണി കോളേജ് ഓഫ് എഞ്ചിനീയറിംഗ് ആൻഡ് ടെക്നോളജി.
ഫസ്റ്റ് ഓഫ് ഓൾ ലെറ്റ്സ് പ്രേ ദ ഓൾ മൈറ്റി റിക്കവറിംഗ് ഹിസ് ബ്ലെസിംഗ്സ് ഫ്രം ദ പെർഫെക്ട് കണ്ടക്ഷൻ ഓഫ് ദിസ് ഫംഗ്ഷൻ. ലെറ്റ്സ് ഓൾ സ്റ്റാർട്ട് ദ പ്രോഗ്രാം വിത്ത് തമിഴ് തായ് വാഴ്ത്ത്.
Our friend Miss M. A. Gopika to blissfully initiate the function with a beautiful traditional dance.
ta jum
Our symposium ceremony, I warmly invite our beloved delegates to kindly grace their presence onto the stage.
I would like to invite our principal, Dr. to the stage. I would like to invite our chief guest, Dr. K. Udayakumar, to the stage. I would like to invite our HOD, Professor P. Jayakumar, to the stage. I would like to invite our Humanity HOD, Dr. V. S. Madhu Suresh, to the stage. I would like to invite our ECE HOD, Dr. S. Mohana Lakshmi, to the stage. I would like to invite our Civil HOD, Dr. J. Sahaya Ruban, to the stage. I would like to invite our CSE HOD, Professor R. Shahila Devi, to the stage. I would like to invite our Mechanical HOD, Dr. D. Prince Sahaya Sudarshan, to the stage. I would like to invite our placement officer, Dr. G. K. Jabba Samuel, to the stage. I would like to invite our Professor Dr. D. Sam Harrison to the stage. I would like to invite our Association Secretary, Mr. D. Kanirajan, to the stage. Thank you.
A festival is always considered auspicious with the light of glory and fragrance of blessings. I would like to welcome our delegates to light the Kuthuvilakku and inaugurate this function.
Invite our second year student JP Harishma Jay to deliver the welcome address.
A very good morning to everyone present here. I consider it a great privilege to welcome all the dignitaries for this auspicious occasion. First of all, I would like to welcome our honorable chairman, Sri K. Neelamartanan, who constantly supports for things we do together under his guidance. I express my warm welcome to our pro chairman, Dr. N. Neelavishnu. This function would have been possible without his magnification, encouragement and support. We remain grateful to you and we welcome you for being with us always. I would like to welcome our beloved principal, Dr. R. Rajesh, for all words of wisdom that radiated a source of energy within us. His kind guidance helped us in strengthening the program in various frameworks. Welcome you, sir. On behalf of our college, I would like to welcome our chief guest, Dr. K. Udayakumar, Deputy Director, Center of University Industries Collaboration. And he will grace us with his presence in his technical environment. Welcome you, sir. Next, I would like to welcome our beloved head of the department and vice principal, Professor P. Jayakumar, for his encouragement and enthusiastic guidance for making this day successful. Welcome you, sir. I would like to welcome the high authorities of all the disciplines of our college to this beautiful occasion. Their presence and wishes will always grace our develop. Welcome you all, professors. I would like to express my warm welcome to our symposium coordinator, Dr. Sir, a heartfelt welcome to all of our faculties who always stand by us, guide us, leaders and motivate us. I would like to heartfully welcome all the participants for various reputed institutions for this technical occasion. Welcome your friends. Last but not least, I would like to welcome all my dear friends for their wonderful occasion. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Harishma.
It's my pleasure to invite our beloved head of the department, Professor P. Jayakumar, to deliver the introductory speech.
Good morning, all of you. On behalf of Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering, I welcome you all for the technical symposium, LEQR 2K22. I heartfully thank our management for giving permission and supporting us to conduct this event. I welcome our founder chairman, Sri K. Neela Marthandam, our pro chairman, Dr. N. Neela Vishnu, our managing director, Dr. V. M. Blasigio, and our respected principal, Dr. R. Rajesh, and today's honorable chief guest, Dr. K. Udayakumar, for this grand function, and all the HODs of different departments. On behalf of Feeders Triple E Association, we have conducted a 2 days hands-on training on electric vehicles for our students during the month of March 2022. And today, the LEQR 2K22 is organized to enhance and empower the technical perspective of our students and participants for various reputed institutions. Around 150 students from 20 colleges are present here with us. With God's grace, let us all empower our technical perspective through this event. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your inspiring speech.
It's my pleasure to invite our respected principal, Dr. R. Rajesh, to deliver the presidential address.
Respected chairman in absentia, respected pro chairman, respected managing director, the beloved head department of electrical and electronics engineering and the vice principal of RCET, Professor K. Jayakumar, the honored chief guest of the day, Sri Dr. Udayakumar, Deputy Director, Center for Industry, Institute and Interaction, Anna University, Chennai, Dr. D. Sam Harrison, Deputy HOD, and Dr. Jabas Samuel, Placement Officer and Convener of this symposia, and Mr. Kaniraj, heads of various departments, the faculties, supporting staff, and my dear beloved students. Very good morning to all. Today, the Department of Triple E of RCET is organizing national level technical symposia in the name of Electria 2022. So you people have organized this symposia in a different way, in a colorful way, in an enjoyable way. I appreciate the effort taken by, the hard work taken by the head department of electrical and electronics engineering, Professor K. Jayakumar, Dr. D. Sam Harrison, our placement officer, Professor Jabas Samuel, Professor Ponchalvan, Professor Murugan, Professor Gopakumar, Professor Periyaswamy, Professor Bhaskar, Professor Sanchu, Professor Patmakumar, Professor Nitya, Professor Dr. Amudapriya and all my Professor Prem Kumar and all our colleagues for their painstaking effort to make this function in a wonderful way. So this function is entirely different from the other functions. You have started the symposium in a different way. I appreciate Ms. Gobiga. She had performed well for the beginning of this program. And you also organized e-vehicle expo. இது நம்ம ட்ரிபிளி உடைய ப்ரோக்ராம். அண்ட் மை டியர் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ், எலக்ட்ரிக்கல் இன்ஜினியரிங் இஸ் அன் எவர் கிரீன் இன்ஜினியரிங் ஃபீல்ட். வேர் எவர் வி கோ, வாட் எவர் தி அப்ளிகேஷன்ஸ் வி ஆர் யூசிங், வெதர் மேபி அ ஹோம் அப்ளையன்ஸ் ஆர் மேபி அ டொமஸ்டிக் அப்ளையன்ஸ் ஆர் மேபி இண்டஸ்ட்ரி அப்ளையன்ஸ், த ரோல் ஆஃப் எலக்ட்ரிக்கல் அண்ட் எலக்ட்ரானிக்ஸ் இன்ஜினியரிங் இஸ் இம்மென்ஸ். வி ஆர் ஸ்பீக்கிங் இன் ஃப்ரண்ட் ஆஃப் யர் மைக் அண்ட் வி ஆர் என்ஜாயிங் பை கெட்டிங் தி எலக்ட்ரிக் பவர் சப்ளை. If you imagine that, if a power supply is failed for an hour, so what are the things will be happening? Just to imagine, no internet, no online classes being conducted, no online bank transactions being conducted. Nowadays, even that the medical transactions, medical surgery are conducting with the help of the internet only, with the help of the robotics only. So power sources are now electric vehicles. So all the applications, even the government, has failed on a particular day. So we practically experienced this kind of the situations during the OKI fuel. During the OKI fuel period, and we had faced a severe power cut problem. 2 days, no power is available in Kanyakumari district. We people have faced a very difficult situation during that time. So on that time, everybody in Kanyakumari district think about the electrical engineers, the electronics engineers. So without you, no electricity is there. Without the electricity, no vehicle move, no transaction takes place. So everything is depending on the electricity. So my dear friends, nowadays the students are having the difficulty to choose the electrical engineering because they have feared that if they have chosen electrical and electronics engineering, how can they complete the course? That is a wrong opinion. It is very easy to finish the electrical and electronics engineering. All the subjects are the fundamental subjects, the basic subjects. So you have to study the subjects with interest. In order to bring the subjects easy to you, our college management has come forward to develop a model laboratory. In a model laboratory, models are deposited, models are showcased, how the EMF is induced, what are the different types of the fuses available, what are the different types of the relays available. So when we have studied, we imagined everything. But today, you are practically seeing how the things are happening in the electric field. All the models are displayed in our model laboratory, not only in the model laboratory, in all the other laboratories also, all the fundamental models are displaying here. You have to utilize that kind of the opportunity. And when we are thinking about our electrical and electronics engineering, you people are the highly disciplined people. Every day, the attendance of the electrical engineering is more than 95%. I appreciate all my friends, especially all the class teachers, for making that more than 95% of attendance on each and every day. In this batch, in this fine 2022 batch, two Manipuri girls are there, Nira and Zira. So you people have given full cooperation for those girls. We didn't face any kind of the complaint from those girls. I appreciate all our final year students. And my dear friends, my humble request is, nowadays lot of job opportunities are available everywhere. Even yesterday itself, one company from Chennai requested me to organize a campus interview. and they need electrical and mechanical engineering students, that minimum salary is 22,000 per month. And similarly, we have organized, with the help of our placement officer, we have organized lot of placement interviews in the previous week itself. But you people, the response is not good. You people kindly utilize this kind of the opportunity to participate the campus interview and get a job. If anybody is interesting to join an industry, and you people are permitted to do the to continue the job in industry or to the internship program. Today, we are having a wonderful chief guest, Dr. Uday Kumar. He is our batchmate when we studied in ME program in 1998 and 1999. And he is our batchmate. And we people are very much happy that today he occupied the topmost position as a deputy director in the Anna University, it's in a College of Engineering, Guindy. Not only in College of Engineering, Guindy, in all the affiliated colleges, he is the deputy director for the industry institute interaction. He is the man to organize the centralized placement and kindly utilize this kind of the people. He is a busy man. So despite of our request, he may make his presence today. So definitely his lecture, his advice would be very much useful to you to enrich your technical minds and enhance your career also. So once again, I request all to update your skills. So these kind of the platforms are being provided to you to expose your hidden talents. And in this time, I would like to mention that and Triple E department, lot of students have participated in other college symposias and conferences and brought laurels to our institutions. I appreciate you all people. So once again, I thank the organizers for organizing the symposia in our campus, and enjoy the symposia. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your inspiring speech. It's my privilege to request our chief guest, Dr. K. Uday Kumar, to release our department magazine. And I request our beloved principal, Dr. R. Rajesh, to receive the magazine. Thank you, sirs.
I am happy to call upon our beloved professor, Dr. D. Sam Harrison, to introduce our chief guest, Dr. K. Uday Kumar, Deputy Director, Center for University Industry Collaboration, Anna University, to the gathering.
Good morning to everybody. Now I am going to introduce our chief guest, Dr. K. Uday Kumar. He completed his BE degree from KSR College of Engineering and Technology, University Madras, in the year 1994 to 1998. And he completed his ME degree program from Faculty of Engineering, Annamalai University, in the year 1998 and 1999. And he completed his PhD degree from Anna University in the year 2001 to 2009. The title is Design of Advanced Robust Controller for Variable Structure System. His area of specialization is linear and nonlinear system, modeling and control, renewable energy sources, power converters and energy storage system, sensor and transducers, micro electromechanical systems, soft computing and optimization, machine learning on artificial intelligence, measurement and instrumentation, and professional ethics. He is also a life member in various professional organizations such as Indian Society for Technical Education, Society of India, life member in Society of Power Engineers, life member in Quality Circle Forum of India, and life member in Viba India. And he guided 6 scholars and guiding 1 scholar at present. He also published 28 international journals and various papers presented in various international and national programs. And also he chaired and organized attend more than 50 programs. And also he invited lecturers for 44 programs in various colleges. At present, he is working as a professor in Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering, College of Engineering, Guindy. And also his additional responsibility is Deputy Director, Center for University Industry Collaboration, Anna University, Chennai. So previously, he handled many positions. That is advisor in Robotics Club, College of Engineering, Guindy. Additional Chief Superintendent of Examination, UG, College of Engineering, Guindy. And NRI Students Counselor, Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering, Chennai. Additional Chief Superintendent of Examination, PG Department, Electrical and Electronics Engineering, Chennai. And also a Program Officer for NCC, National Cadet Corps, Anna University, Chennai, during the year 2002-2008. Such a very good, strong administrative capability and high knowledge person is with us. So on behalf of Triple E department and also our principal initially clearly mentioned, Namma Rohini Triple E, a warm welcome you sir. With us is highly appreciated. And also our students are eagerly waiting for your inspiring speech. So now I welcome our chief guest Dr. K. Udayakumar to give you a chief guest address. The Department of Triple E students, LQ 22, do one big clap to welcome our chief guest.
Respected and beloved Principal, Rohini College of Engineering and Technology, Professor Dr. Rajesh, beloved Head of the Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering, Rohini, Professor Dr. Jayakumar sir, and other heads of the departments of various departments, placement officer, and my good old friend, Professor Dr. Sam Harrison, and my dear student friends, very good morning to all of you. Okay. First of all, at the outset, my sincere thanks to the management of Rohini College of Engineering and Technology for having invited me as a chief guest of today's grand event, LQ Yuva 2022. And my personal thanks to Principal and Professor Dr. Sam Harrison also in this connection. Friends, it's indeed overwhelming welcome extended by your enthusiastic students. First of all, I'm really happy to address you all on this great occasion. Especially I'm excited with the welcome dance performance by your fellow student Ms. Gopika, and all your energy level in seeing you all in traditional dress and with some color combo. Really, I'm happy to address all of you students, especially this function being coordinated after a gap of at least for about 2 years after the COVID gap. So we all got stuck due to the COVID lockdowns and various disturbances. Even though the students are happy that their arrears have got cleared, but personally, many of us have got suffered. We lost many lives. So I think these 2 years really were a tough time for all of us invariably. Nevertheless, we come back and we give back, we deliver back in terms of all our offline activities. So in this connection, I'm glad to be part of this, first event in Triple E Rohini after the COVID period. Friends, I'm really, happy that if I'm addressed as professor in electrical engineering, electrical and electronics engineering, in College of Engineering, Guindy, Anna University, rather than Deputy Director in CUIC. So I'm one among the ever excellent electrical engineering, which is Triple E. As your principal rightly pointed out, it is an evergreen program. I'm not just telling you all that you should be excited out of my words. It's not so. There is no engineering without Triple E. Any clue? There is no engineering without Triple E. Just spell out engineering. There are three E's. Correct. There is no engineering without triple E. So that shows the initial, you know, excitement for all of us to take triple E. In fact, today morning when we had interaction with our principal and team Rohini, we were just interacting about the triple E program and why students from higher secondary, they are more reluctant in taking triple E as their career option. Then I just shared my own view. Sometimes students may not be strong enough or confident enough in mathematics. If any one of us are not good in mathematics, probably we may find toughness in solving the problems in electrical engineering. But nevertheless, triple E is one of the bridging course between all the programs. You can handle any mechanical problems. Even in IT domain also, you can handle problems. And what not, instrumentation, control, robotics, in all the fields, out of my experience I'm sharing, I could see a lot of our alumni who just passed out from triple E department. But out of their passion, after going into the industry, they stepped into different domains, as I have mentioned, from different domains, even biotech also. One of our prestigious alumni, Mr. Raj Prakash, was the founder of a company called Zifo, where Zifo is one of the leading organization company in biotechnology. So it is up to us in what level we are taking our passion to the next level, etc. Right? So in this juncture, I would like to initially to orient you all towards some of the technical needs at present. What exactly is required for an electrical engineer to be more successful when they pass out of the degree, when they get into their industry domain or the industrial market? The second phase of my the lecture may be out of the technical things, right? So first of all, as Principal Sir said, without electricity, we cannot run any kind of system. All the systems are dependent on the availability of electricity. But now, if you look at the other domains, like artificial intelligence, machine learning, and soft computing, etc., they are also coming up to their level best. In the sense, I can simply tell you one particular a funny quote. Suppose who is the father of electrical engineering? There are many eminent scientists are there. Edison, let us take Thomas Alva Edison as one of the key person who is representative to triple E. And who is the premier scientist or father of electronics and communication? ECE HOD madam is here. Maybe Faraday. Or Graham Bell, who invented the telephone, right? So the funny thing is like this. If both of them are coming live now, alive, right? Graham Bell, when they look at the technology now happening, right, mobile phone technology, they say they cannot, the Graham Bell himself cannot understand what's going on. At least he can understand. He may take some time to look at the developments that have happened. So the point is, mobile communication have reached their Tamil la solluvaangalla naalgal paichalla paayiron solluvaangalla andha madri. The technologies in the electronics and communication have developed with manifold, multi times. But electrical engineering, if you look at our triple representative Thomas Alva Edison, when he looks at the power engineering technology, forget about e-vehicle, renewable energy, power engineering technology, the smart grid, the grid technology, etc., he may blame on us. What year? You guys are still using the age-old technology in the 1950s, 1940s. Like that, he may blame on us. That's how the comparison is. The point is, still we use the age old technology in power sector. In power sector, if you look at the substations, the powerhouses, the grids, all are still with the same old technology we are running. Even though all of us are really pride about the electricity and its dependency on various domains that they are depending on electricity, that's okay. But still, there are certain challenges are there in making the power to be available to all of us without any fluctuation, without any outages. You know, very quite often we suffer from power outages. When the technologies in the other sector has keep on growing to the level high, then it is the responsibility of the electrical engineers to cater to the needs of all these high expectations. In the sense, you guys, if you come, you are passing out, you must have adequate potential, skills. The principal and head of the department rightly pointed out, you have model laboratories. What were the model laboratories are all there? To think on the theoretical courses with other dimensions. You have to think out of the box. As principal rightly said, in when we studied about electrical engineering in those days, we could only assume what is current, what is charge. But now, you can, with the model, you can get a glimpse of how what exactly is the meaning for all these electrical parameters and how we are going to handle it. All that, some clear picture you get. Nevertheless, we could successfully come up in our own domain. So what is the point here? It is, you guys, if you are capable of grasping the fundamentals adequately along with the required skills. What do you mean by required skills? Who requires that? Any clue? Who is expecting adequate skills from your side? If you are claiming that you are an electrical engineer, where you are going to work? In the industrial sector, right? No, sir. I have got IT job. I am going to work in IT organization. Why I should bother about all these stuffs like current, voltage, power, power factor, etc. That's all. With this 4 years, I am going to forget about all that. Means it's fine. In some place, in some domain, you are going to contribute. But the point is, I'm sure that all of you might agree that if you are seeking a job from any industry, the first and foremost requirement is to on your fundamental domain knowledge. Whether you are attending an interview for marketing, digital marketing, or business analyst, or content writing, whatever may be the job role in different companies. But first the panelist may check your domain knowledge. What is that you have gained in these 4 years? Even though he is from a computer science background, he may ask you what is meant by back EMF, straightforward question. Because the point is, unless you focus on your own committed domain, on what capacity you are going to support the organization for their profit. Correct. The fundamental requirement is that. So the domain knowledge is really important irrespective of the type of jobs you are going to take up. So on this note, as I said, in the power sector, we are still lagging. Even though the electricity is really important, we are unable to cope up with the technological pace developments that have happened in the other sectors. So we need to understand what are the real challenges that are in existence in power industries. I could see that some of you would have visited the industries, and in Feeders magazine you have written some report. So what is my point is, forget about final years, but the third year, second year, first year students, you guys have to visit at least a minimum of 10 industries during your program, EEE program. It is not that IV means tour, going to some places and enjoying out of fun. That's fine. Fun is an other part of our college days. But what is more important is, are we really getting skilled up? So that can be there only if you go and visit the industries as much as possible, because there only you will come to know what are the real challenges. What are the real challenges in transmitting the power from one place to another place, and how the price is fixed? why the tariff is going up, in what capacity we can support the TANGEDCO. What is TANGEDCO? Tamil Nadu Generation and Distribution Corporation. The old name is was TNEB, Tamil Nadu Electricity Board. They suffer a lot. If you simply see, it's not that you have to go to Chennai or Hyderabad or any other Visakhapatnam to see the super facilities of industries. Your own places have got substations and power grids are there, private wind farms are there. So you have to go and look at the real challenges in generating the power and how efficiently the power is transmitted and how the various power vendors are involved in trading the power, and finally how the price is fixed. So if you really look at it, the real scenario is because of lot of policy level discriminations, at the end level our customers, we are getting suffered. Ella and the power outage la nadakkira losses and the power related issues nala, the price is huge, and all these losses and the compensating money is loaded on the end level users like us. So we are paying, right? So these sort of issues you budding engineers can only solve. You can go and work for IT industry and contribute to IT domain, but no computer science and IT students can come to electricity board and solve the issue. Who can solve the issue? Only you can solve the issues. So this is a pertaining issue. At least the Tamil Nadu Electricity Board, that is TANGEDCO, is performing well when compared to the other states. But the real challenge, the technical challenge now is, apart leaving the power related issues, the integration of renewable energy. So we just see on the in the bypass when we go, we see a lot of windmills, it is rotating, generating some power. We don't even apply our mind, being an electrical engineer, somebody asks what type of generator that is applied in the wind power, wind energy conversion system. We don't know. We, in the sense, students are, they don't bother about knowing the what is available in the renewable energy sources. So, out of all these issues, they could generate the RE means renewable energy powers also, and they try their level best to integrate it with the existing power grids. The challenge is, unlike the thermal energy and hydro energy, the frequency of power availability here, it is very less. So we cannot pump in the power supply to the existing grid just like that. The frequency mismatch will be there, and then you need to work a lot on the shunt capacitors, power factor compensation, like that. Lot of challenging issues are there. So you guys are smart in both electrical engineering with the other courses also. So how efficiently, for example, if you are good in machine learning algorithms can be applied to optimally solve the power flow issues. Likewise, you can think of applying the other domain expertise also into your domain, so that interdisciplinary can really solve the issue much better in quicker time. So that is what is expected by the power industries nowadays. Similarly, the other industries, if you look at, I'm not saying that completely electrical engineering is going down. Only in this sake, power generation, distribution, power utilization side, we find certain lackness. But the other side, if you look at, rightly you have exhibited your expo on an e-vehicle. E-vehicle technology is a upcoming technology. Though there are some of the pitfalls, like in WhatsApp videos you would have seen, like some of the e-vehicle e-scooties are getting burned, right? All these issues are really solvable issues, because we have not yet come to the level of matured battery technology. So that issues are getting sorted out. So e-vehicle technology is coming up. Nevertheless, Tesla is one of the premier autonomous cars, e-vehicle cars. They are pioneer in the autonomous cars. So in the US market, the deadline for getting a complete shift from IC engines to e-vehicle is 2030. In 2030, all the conventional cars are going to be completely, that will be a paradigm shift in the industry. They are going to be 100% e-vehicle market. But we are not far away from US market. So we maybe instead of 2030, we may achieve that level in 2040 or 2050. So anyway, the point is, in future, the complete automobile industry is going to depend on the electrical engineers, because all the petrol bunks will be replaced by charging stations. Even now, with the available loads, we are suffering to give the power in a smoother manner. There are a lot of fluctuations, power cuts are there. But just think about exponential growth in the demand side. Demand side, if most of the charging stations are coming up, the demand is really multifold. So are we prepared to meet out such demand? No. As it is, no. But in future, the young budding engineers like you should really think about these challenges that are there in the industry side, so that innovatively, how efficiently you can transform the, you can enjoy the transformation between the IC engines to the e-vehicle is really a big question mark, unless you put effort to your level best. So this is one part of the technical part which I wanted to share. The crux of the first phase of my ideas is this. You guys should know the real challenges that are there in the existing industrial scenario. அது தெரியாம நம்ம எதுக்காக படிக்கிறோம், யாருக்காக ஒர்க் பண்ண போறோம், எதை சால்வ் பண்ண போறோம்னே தெரியாம ஒரு டிகிரி வாங்கிட்டு மார்க்கெட்ல போய் நிக்கிறது வேஸ்ட், ரைட்? அதர்வைஸ் யூ ஆர் வேஸ்டிங் யுவர் ஓன் டைம், மணி ஆஃப் யுவர் பேரண்ட்ஸ், எனர்ஜி ஆஃப் யூ அஸ் வெல் அஸ் யுவர் பேரண்ட்ஸ் ஆல், ரைட்? சோ தி பாயிண்ட் இஸ் யூ ஷுட் பி ரியலி அவேர் ஆஃப் தி ரெக்யர்மெண்ட்ஸ். தட் இஸ் வாட் ஐ ஹிண்டட் த வேர்ட் லைக் ரெக்யர்மெண்ட்ஸ். சோ ரெக்யர்மெண்ட்ஸ் பை ஹூம்? By the industries, the real requirements. The point is, another challenging aspect of the student's career here, it is job placement. So my additional role in Anna University, as your principal and the Professor Sam Harrison mentioned, is as a deputy director in university industry collaboration, where the routine job is inviting companies to CEG, MIT, SC Tech campuses of Anna University, and throughout the year placement is happening. At least on a daily basis, there are two companies visiting Anna University, predominantly IT industries. 60-70% of the companies visiting are all IT industries. Of course, mechanical and electrical and petroleum, chemical core industries are also visiting. So my role there, it is to interact with the companies, right, and to know about their requirements and conveying these requirements to the respective branch students and generating the interested and eligible student database based on their requirement and sharing it with the company. And after the after that, we are giving a schedule to their visit, right? And post which, my team members will take care of their on the day of process, they will conduct the process. And they will announce the shortlist and finally selected students list. Friends, you won't believe that you may think that Anna University has got a premier campus recruitment and all that. But still, from my point of view internally, I feel that still it is lagging. In the sense, the industry requirements during their PowerPoint, pre-placement talk, I could see that what is their expectation. The other side, if I look at it, the student side, only the toppers and to some extent, some percentage of students could cope up with that. But the rest of the other students, if you look at, though they are 8-pointers or 9-pointers, still they are not meeting the requirements of the industries. And that is what is my point. I am driving down this message to you. You try to equip yourself, to try to excel yourself to the requirements of the industries, then only you can go and proudly, you can ask the panelists to give you a job. Otherwise, it's something like, when you sit with the panel member, by just looking at your face, your attitude, your confidence level, it takes only hardly maximum of 2 minutes to reject you. Right? Not more than that. The panelists, they don't want to spend much more time if they come to a conclusion that you are unfit to interview you further. Means that's all. next candidate. Right? So that is the situation. There are plenty of engineers are there, including electrical engineers from every other institutions. Right? So the competition, if you go out of the campus, is really big. So unless you are really skilled, then, you know, it's really, I'm not saying that it is tough, but it may delay your success in achieving the career position. It will delay, right? Because we will learn in that particular time period, and because it is, you know, survival. Survival fact will definitely push you to learn to the level best, and then you will approach the companies for job. But rather, if you are prepared now itself, it will be a good start for your career option. Second, as your principal pointed out, we are the coordinators for the program called Tamil Nadu State Level Placement Program. Enna sir, unga campus mattum dhaan placement panduvingala, engalukku ellaam panna mattingala appdin kettingana, there is a program called Tamil Nadu State Level Placement Program. Quite often the students, they call the drive, hiring placement drive, as off campus nu solliranga. Nothing wrong, but the main the program name is Tamil Nadu State Level Placement Program, that we are coordinating by identifying the nodal centers across Tamil Nadu, Chennai, Madurai, Coimbatore, Tirunelveli, and whatnot. Why not? Now in Nagarkoil also we conducted the drive, especially for the bulk recruiters. Bulk recruiters in the sense Infosys, Cognizant, and TCS, Wipro, Accenture kind of companies. Depending on their requirement, year on year, for the past 2 decades, CUIC, that is our center, coordinated this process, and hardly around 60,000 students who have passed out of affiliated colleges like you have got placed in these companies. Nichima in that you kai tattano, because I am right, because the point is 60,000 students namma simple ah sollirrom. We have enlightened 60,000 families. That's how we are looking at it. Because when the companies, they, yeah, thank you. Companies, you know, you would have heard a program called CSR. What is CSR? Corporate Social Responsibility. Correct. Likewise, Anna University, unlike any other universities across the Indian states, have initiated such a nice program for the affiliated college students. University oda role degree kudukuradhu mattum dhaan, right? There is no bound or commitment with the university side to give an opportunity, placement opportunity to students. But the visionary vice chancellor at that point in time in 2003, Professor Dr. Bala Gurusamy, only initiated, hey guys, you are inviting around 200 to 250 companies to our campus. Why don't you talk to them and you give opportunity to other affiliated college students also? And that's how it got initiated. And so far around 65,000 students have got placed through this campus. Even before COVID period, we conducted a last drive in Infosys drive here in one of the colleges in Nagarkoil, right? So probably you would have got this message from your seniors or placement officer regarding this. So after which the things have changed, drives are happening online. Anybody can apply and through these companies and write the online test and get cleared. But now we are talking with the companies to revive the model of TNSLPP again for the benefit of students. So anytime for 2022 batch or 2023 batch passing out students, you may get a good news that TNSLPP will come back, right? So be prepared. At any point in time, the opportunity may knock at your door, and you guys should put effort maximum. Daivathagadaninum muyarchi than meivarutta Kooli Dharum. So please do remember this Thirukkural, and the kai thattu the Thirukkural ka illa na mudigenu solradhuka. Okay, so the effort what you put will definitely will yield a better successful metric to you. So with this, I don't want to take much of your time. I heard that there are a good number of participants have registered in your event from other colleges also. Definitely the events like technical events like LQA 2022 will give many more opportunities to sharpen your technical skills. Make use of these technical events, and you also should participate in other colleges and try to know their level of technical knowledge and calibrate yourself and reduce your error. And that's how you can come up in your fundamentals, and you can boldly meet any industry interview panels, right? So with these few words, thank you so much for all of you for inviting me. Best wishes.
Thank you, sir, for your precious speech.
I am happy to call upon our beloved head of the department to honor the chief guest.
I request our chief guest to honor the heads of all departments. Professor P. Jayakumar, head of the department, Tripoli. Dr. D. Prince Sahaya Sudarshan, head of the department, Mechanical. Dr. V. S. Madhusuresh, head of the department, Humanities Department. Dr. S. Mohanalakshmi, head of the department, ECE. Dr. D. Sahaya Ruban, head of the department, Civil. Thank you, sir.
I request HOD sir to honor our department faculty members. Dr. D. Sam Harrison, Professor Tripoli. Dr. G. K. Jabaz Samuel, Placement Officer, RCET. Mr. G. Murugan, Assistant Professor, Tripoli. Mr. V. Ponselvan, Assistant Professor, Tripoli. Mr. S. Gopakumar, Assistant Professor, Tripoli. Mrs. S. Nithya, Assistant Professor, Tripoli. Mr. C. Bhaskar, Assistant Professor, Tripoli. Mr. R. Batma Kumar, Assistant Professor, Tripoli. Mr. S. Sanju, Assistant Professor, Tripoli. Dr. N. Amuda Priya, Associate Professor, Tripoli. Mr. M. Jibin, Assistant Professor, Tripoli. Mr. D. Periasamy, Assistant Professor, Tripoli. Mr. Suresh, Technical Assistant, Tripoli. Ms. S. Renuga Devi, Technical Assistant, Tripoli. Thank you, sir.
Collective work is the secret behind the process. Thank you is a prayer that has to be felt by heart. Now I call upon our association secretary, Mr. D. Kanirajan, to deliver the vote of thanks.
A very good morning to everyone present here. I consider it a great privilege to propose a vote of thanks to all dignitaries who have witnessed it as a memorable and successful event. First of all, I would like to thank our honorable chairman, Sri K. Neelamarthandan, for his constant support for things we do together under his guidance. Thank you, sir. I express my sincere gratitude to our pro-chairman, Dr. N. Neela Vishnu. This function would not have been possible without his magnificent encouragement and support. Thank you, sir. I am very glad to thank our managing director, Dr. V. M. Blissy Gio. We will ever remain grateful to you, and we thank you for being with us always. Thank you, ma'am. I would like to thank our beloved principal, Dr. R. Rajesh, for all words of wisdom that radiated a source of energy within us. His kind guidance helped us in strengthening the program in various frameworks. Thank you, sir. I would like to express my sincere thanks to our beloved head of the department and vice principal, Professor P. Jayakumar, for his encouragement and meticulous guidance for making this day successful. Thank you, sir. Today, my words are not enough to express the gratitude. On behalf of our college, I would like to thank our chief guest, Dr. K. Udaykumar, Deputy Director, Center of University Industry Collaboration, Anna University, who has graced us with his thought-provoking speech. Thank you, sir. Beloved, thanks to our coordinators, Dr. Sam Harrison, Professor at Tripoli, and Dr. G.K. Jabba Samuels, Placement Officer or CET, for their sincere and dedicated involvement to make this day a memorable one. I would like to thank the HODs of all the disciplines of our college for their valuable presence during this beautiful occasion. Thank you, professors. Heartfelt thanks to all our faculties who always stand by us, guide us, lead us, and motivate us. We feel proud and thank you for making us feel happy with your presence to this function. I would like to express my sincere thanks to all my participants from various reputed institutions for making this wonderful day. Thank you, friends. Last but not least, I would like to thank all my friends for your involvement and contribution for making this event a grand success. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you, Mr. Ganirajan.
In this inspiring moment, I would like to welcome our Pro Chairman, Managing Director, Principal, Heads of all disciplines, our dear faculty members, participants from reputed institutions, and my dear friends to the valedictory function of our Tripoli Department, Technical Symposium LFQR 2K22.
Thank you. பாய் மூடி பாய போறேன் பெருங்காலில விண்படி போன பிறப்பா இருந்தாலும் மறைஞ்சேன் இருந்தனும் 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 என்ன பிளாக் அண்ட் ஒயிட் கண்ணு உன்னை பார்த்தா கலரா மாறுபிடிச்ச காதல் நினைத்த சுறுசுறுப்பாக சீருதே அவ பேசி அனதா மொத்தத்துல
Yeah. என்ன பண்ண முடியும்?
ஆமா சார், நீங்க சொன்ன மாதிரி எங்களுக்கு தைரியம் இருந்ததில்ல, நம்பிக்கை இருந்ததில்ல, சக்தியே இருந்ததில்ல. சாவு எங்க மேல குதியாட்டம் போட்டுச்சு. அப்ப குறுக்க நின்றுட்டு இருந்த ஒருத்தன் அந்த மாரியாத்தா முன்னாடி தலை சேவினால அவன் செத்த அன்னைக்கு ரொம்ப வருஷத்துக்கு அப்புறம் சாவு மேல நாங்க குறியாட்டம் போட்டோம். அவன் கத்தி வீசின வேகத்துல ஒரு புயலே உருவாகிச்சு சார். அந்த புயல் நகாச்சல இருக்கிற ஒவ்வொருத்தருக்கும் உசுர குடத்துக்கு. உங்களுக்கு ஒரு யோசனை சொல்றேன், நீங்க மட்டும் அவன் குறுக்க போயிடாதீங்க சார்.
தோல் பறக்கத மம்பட்டி அட மம்பட்டியா எட்டத்துக்கும் கோடி பறக்கத மம்பட்டி அட மம்பட்டியா எட்ட கூட கலகலக்கத மம்பட்டி அட மம்பட்டியா பத்த கூட பாட பறக்கத மம்பட்டி அட மம்பட்டியா அட மம்பட்டியா அட மம்பட்டியா
ஒரு மாதிரி இருக்கடா
ஏன் வயிறு சரியில்லையா
அது இல்லடா நான் கூட இப்ப லவ்லாம் பண்றேன் சினிமால பாத்துருக்கேன் பீச்ல பாத்துருக்கேன் நம்ம கிளாஸ்ல கூட பாத்துருக்கேன் ஆனா இப்போ நான் ஒரு பொண்ணு லவ்
பண்றேன் நதியே எங்கே என்று கரைகள் தேடக்கூடாதா நிலவே எங்கே என்று முகில்கள் தேடக்கூடாதா
லவ் பண்ணுங்க சார் லைஃப் நல்லா இருக்கும்
ஏண்டா லவ் பண்ணி வீணா போறீங்க
ஒரு ஐடியா சொல்லவா அரபிக் குத்து அரபிக் குத்து ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ணலாமா
ஹல்லமத்தி ஹபீபோ ஹல்லமத்தி ஹபீப் வந்தாலே ஹல்லமத்தி ஹபீபோ ஹல்லமத்தி ஹபீப் வந்தா ஹல்லமத்தி ஹபீபோ ஹல்லமத்தி ஹபீப் வந்தாலே ஹல்லமத்தி ஹபீபோ ஹல்லமத்தி ஹபீபோ
மா மா என்ன வந்திருக்காக, மாப்பிள்ள மொக்கச்சாமி வந்திருக்காக, மற்றும் நம் உறவினர்கள்லாம் வந்திருக்காக. பாமா மின்னல்
Listen to the rhythm of Chennai.
Thank you. பிராங்க் பண்ண கேமரா பண்ணுங்க கேமரா.
என்ன பாட்டை நிறுத்திட்டீங்க? பட்டே கலப்ப
நான் இருக்கேன், மஞ்சள் அரைக்க நிவாரியா, நஞ்ச வெளியா நான் இருக்கேன், நாத்து நட நிவாரியா, திருவிடாவா நான் இருக்கேன், உரியடிக்க நிவாரியா, வைக்காலா நான் இருக்கேன், வழிமறிக்க நிவாரியா, பனமரமா நான் இருக்கேன், கல்லெடுக்க நிவாரியா, பந்த காலா நான் இருக்கேன், கூரப்பின்ன நிவாரியா, கரமேடா நான் இருக்கேன், செலம்பு சித்த நிவாரியா, பஞ்சாரமா நான் இருக்கேன், கொழி பிடிக்க நிவாரியா, முந்திரி காடா நான் இருக்கேன், நரிவரக்க நிவாரியா, நான் ராக்கு முத்து ராக்கு என்ன தொட்டு கத்தா சாக்கு, அட நாக்கு முழி மூக்கு எல்லாம் நல்ல நல்ல சொக்கு, இது ஆம்பளைய பார்க்காத காக்கு என அப்படியே அள்ளி எடுத்து போக்கு, இது ஆம்பளைய பார்க்காத காக்கு என அப்படியே அள்ளி எடுத்து போக்கு,
புலி சிலம்பத்திலே சிங்கம், வாழ்நாள் எல்லாம் கன்னி பெண்களை ஏறெடுத்தும் பார்க்காத கட்டிடம் காளை, புயல் மாதிரி வந்து கொண்டிருக்கிறார் மாஸ்டர் புல்லட் பாண்டி, இதோ வந்து விட்டார்.
Local ਨਾ ਪਰਤ ਗਿਰਤੇ ਆ ਨੋ ਡਾ ਡਾਂਸ ਇਹ ਬਾਟੀ ਕਾ ਦੇ ਬੰਦੇ ਕੁਸ਼ਟ ਪਰਮੇ ਦੇ ਬੈਂ ਪਲਚ ਨੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਉਟਲਾ ਮੋ ਸੁੰਡਾ ਇਸ ਗੁੰਡਾ ਨੂੰ ਪਸਤੇ ਜੋਟਾ ਲਿਆ ਉਟਾ ਦਾ ਜੋਟਾ ਤੁਕਨ ਤੋਟਾ ਦਾ ਕਰਤਾ ਕਤਨ ਮਰਦਾ ਦਾ ਪਰ ਪੜ ਵਿੱਚ ਬੈ ਜੋਟਾ ਲੈ ਇਹ ਜੋਟਾ ਲਿਆ ਉਟਾ ਦਾ ਜੋਟਾ ਤੁਕਨ ਤੋਟਾ ਦਾ ਕਰਤਾ ਕਤਨ ਮਰਦਾ ਦਾ ਪਰ ਪੜ ਵਿੱਚ ਬੈ ਜੋਟਾ ਲੈ
Rice distribution in paper presentation. First prize goes to Mohammad Rashid M. And the another first prize goes to Bala Praveen Kumar R. University College of Engineering Nagarkoil. And the second prize goes to Narsis Mol NJ. And the next prize goes to Ashika M. from Arunachala College of Engineering. In quiz competition, first prize goes to Alrin Gino and Anthony Ronald from CSA Institute of Technology. And the second prize goes to Andrew Jones Sujit Kumar from CAPE Institute of Technology. In connection event, first prize goes to Velaitha Perumal Triple E Final Year Ponjasli College. In connection event, second prize goes to Sahana Fatima Triple E Third Year Arunachala College. In Mehendi, first prize goes to Ansha Holy Cross College Nagarkoil. And the second prize goes to Yubilet Adarsha Holy Cross College of Nagarkoil. In Foodie, first prize goes to Anushak Universal College of Engineering. And the second prize goes to A. Sujin Universal College of Engineering. Site on site, first prize goes to Dorothy Christine DR College, University College of Engineering. Site on site, second prize goes to Anthony Ronald, CSA Institute of Technology.
Let us all stand up for national anthem.